Two things you need to know about the new Crook & Marker spiked sodas. One, a couple of their flavors are probably the best tasting low carb alcohol on the market. And number two, hey there, NJRoute22.com with another alcohol, low carb kind of review. It's about the Crook & Marker spiked soda. We have reviewed Crook & Marker in the past. They have flavored seltzers that we sort of liked. They were fairly low carb, I think 1 or 2 grams per can. And the only problem we had was that they were a little more costly than the usual seltzers, such as Natural Light and Smirnoff Spiked Sparkling Seltzer. And they also had a very highly sweet taste because of the erythritol they put in there. It was almost too sweet to the point where we couldn't drink it full strength. But like I said in my intro, the number one, they have four flavors, by the way. They have cola, root beer. These are the ones I have here. Classic cola and root beer. These are very good and our favorite flavors. And the other two flavors they have in their lineup are ginger ale and lemon lime, which we did not like at all, full strength. We still can drink them. We drank what we bought, but we're probably not gonna buy them again. We were able to mix it like we do in our little lab, our alcohol lab, and we mix them and make our own little cocktails, such as this. This is 1/4 can of root beer, another 1/4 can of lemon lime, and 1/2 a can of Smirnoff Spiked Sparkling Seltzer, and the rest is just non-alcoholic seltzer, and it's delicious. Man, I feel like I'm at a summer picnic. It's really that good. But the number two thing you got to worry about, and it is about the sugar. We're very concerned. We've done vlogs in the past. I don't link boxes on YouTube here. I just don't have the time to do it. I just publish my videos. We're concerned about the sweet sensation. We don't think it's normal for people to eat sweet tasting things, especially sugar, because that messes you up. Just look at everybody. But and then the original round of artificial sweeteners were the worst. They made you more fat than the actual sugar did. And now we have the latest round of artificial sugars, which claim to not impact your blood sugar. And we sort of kind of can concur with that because we've dabbled with it for a little bit here and there, not nonstop, but it hasn't caused us to gain weight. However, it does something to us psychosomatically. That's when you believe something even though it's not actually in you. Like a sugar pill is a psychosomatic or whatever. Anyway, it does something to us. I think the sweet sensation on your taste buds sends signals to your brain and something's not connecting in your body. I don't know. I find myself maybe drinking a little bit more of these erythritol sweetened drinks, especially the super sweet ones like the Crook & Marker. I find myself enjoying them and drinking them faster, almost like I did when I used to blindly chug diet Snapples and diet Dr. Peppers. But that's about it. I mean, we do like these. These are good. We'll keep them in rotation. And like I said, I only drink 1/4 can at a time. It's 1/4 can out of a nearly, it's 11.5 ounces. It's, you know, for 3 ounces of Crook & Marker spiked soda in this giant 32-ounce cup. It provides that much flavor that it will make this taste like root beer or cola or whatever. It's fantastic. So I recommend these. I think they're costly. They're like $8 for 4 cans. That's $2 a can. You can get Smirnoff Spiked Sparkling Seltzer for a little over $1 a can when you buy it by the case at like places like ShopRite Liquor. But that's it. What do you think? Do you think they're good? Do you enjoy them? Is the erythritol a good thing, a bad thing? I don't know. Please hit the like and subscribe, and I'll see you next video.